let's just say, I'll just do first year interest group.
Okay.
We'll just keep it general. So tell me your name, your major, and what your small group is this semester.
My name is Miranda Weed, and I'm a biology, hopefully pre-med major, and I'm in a first year interest group.
Okay. Tell me a little bit about some of the concerns that you had in transitioning from high school into the college environment.
Coming into college, I was really concerned about, first of all, meeting new people, and then also just adjusting to like the studying, because I'd heard a lot about how different it is from high school to college and just like the transition academically. So.
Can we start real quick?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I just need to move your mic. Can you move your mic a little bit more, I guess, central?
Central.
So that I can get you here.
Okay.
Is that rubbing against your shirt? Okay.
It might be, let me see. Is there somewhere else I can, should I like put my hair behind my shoulders and like?
If you could, that
okay.
Would be great.
And just like put it back in the same spot?
Yes.
Okay.
Are you able to maintain that, you think, or?
I hope so.
We're gonna have to get a hair tech for you.
All right, so we'll do that one more time.
Okay.
We can get another take. Tell me a little bit about some of the concerns that you had in transitioning from high school and into college.
Coming from high school to college, I was very concerned about, first of all, meeting new people since it's such a big campus, and then second of all, just adjusting the studying from high school to college, because I'd heard a lot about how different it was coming from high school into college, like academically. So I was very concerned about that transition for sure.
Were there ways in which your small group helped to facilitate that transition?
I would definitely say I met a lot of people in my small group. And also, I made connections with, first of all, Sineha, which is my leader of the first year interest group. And she really helped to like kind of let you know what you needed to do to transition. And just meeting people that you could study with definitely helped to get like groups together.
I'm going to ask you to do it one more time. Can we take her?
Not tonight. Okay.
Yeah, I'm just
sorry.
That's okay. Just call her like your peer mentor.
Okay.
Or something like that. Right. Yeah, we're just going to keep it anonymous.
Okay.
As much as she would probably be happy mm-hmm. with the shout out. So tell me a little bit about ways in which your small group helped you to facilitate that transition from high school into college.
With the small group, you definitely met a lot of people in your major. So you had people to study with in groups. And also, having a first year interest group leader, they helped you understand what you needed to do to transition from high school to college, a little bit about like what they'd found from their academics and things like that. And also having an advisor, it helped to be able to know what classes to take and just know academically what you needed to do.
What were some resources that you found on campus during this first semester that were particularly beneficial for you?
I'd say definitely my advisor was a big resource. Being able to go talk to him whenever I needed to ask about future classes or current classes, it was definitely good to be able to go talk to him if I needed to. Also, one thing that I found was the interactive degree audit, which is where you can see what classes you need to take for your major and if you're on the right track to graduating on time in 4 years.
Yay, shout out. So you touched on this a little bit with your academic advisor already, and you talked about self-advising, so you kind of covered my next couple of questions.
Okay.
Were there other resources on campus that you took advantage of, maybe in other areas, things like tutoring, student health services, undergraduate writing center, like any of the places around campus, like offices you've been to?
Okay. I did go to the undergraduate writing center, and it was a big help. In my undergraduate studies class, he really encouraged us to go there and get help on all of our essays. And we got to sit down, and they helped me like proofread my paper and stuff. And that was really nice to have a second opinion on what you had already written.
about a positive faculty or TA interaction that you have this semester?
In my first year interest group, we got to meet with my chemistry professor, and the class is huge, it's 500 people, so to be able to just sit there and like with only 20 people and listen to him talk, you got a better feel for who he was as a person, and it made it a lot less scary to like go up to him and approach him in the future.
So this is one of the open-ended questions, right? And I'm kind of running through all of these, and we'll probably go back through and do another take or two on each, but what is something that you discovered during this semester?
I definitely would say I discovered a lot about myself this semester, a lot about what I thought about college turned out being kind of wrong, and just knowing more about the college. I don't know what I'm saying. I'm sorry.
That's okay. We can check in. Tell me a little bit about something that you discovered.
Something that I discovered. I mean,
what were some of the things that you thought college was going to be like?
I didn't think it was going to be as hard.
That's
as it
great.
Is.
That is a
perfect talk about.
Okay, so should I start talking about that?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so whenever I came to college, I guess I had a different idea of what it would be like. I definitely thought it was going to be more similar to high school than it kind of is. It's definitely a lot harder than I believed it was going to be. But I've also discovered that if you put time and effort into it, you can definitely, you can do it. It's not impossible, and you just have to really put that time and effort into your classes.
Yeah, I mean, that's definitely the kind of thing that an incoming freshman next year can relate to, for sure. What really surprised you during this first semester?
The things that surprised me were kind of how big the classes were and how different they are from high school. I think the fact that you're not like one-on-one with your teacher and that you kind of like sit by different people every day, like you don't get to know everyone in your classes because it's impossible with like 500 people in a class to know the same person that you're sitting by every day. So that definitely surprised me. It was a very big change for me to like not have that tight, close group of people since I came from a pretty small high school. So it's been a lot different, and that surprised me.
Mm-hmm. What for you have been some of the best things about being a part of a small group this first semester?
The small group has definitely facilitated me meeting new people from my major. People who are interested in the same things that I am in the medical field. And just like getting to do fun stuff with them. One time we explored the campus through like a scavenger hunt. We've gone to like union bowling. So it's been really fun. We've done fun things where you really get to know them well, but you also have people that you can study with if you want to study in a group.
Do you have some water?
Do you have some?
We have a drinking fountain.
Okay.
It's okay. It's okay.
You sure?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sorry, I know it's hot under there. You're doing great.
Yeah, you're doing really well.
Yeah.
The other thing too is if sometimes I don't really notice this with you so much. We all have students come in here and they'll give an answer and that will be kind of like their rough draft answer and then they'll give a second answer, which
mm-hmm.
is kind of a refinement of things.
Yeah.
So if you ever feel like you give an answer, but you're not completely satisfied with it, feel free to go, hey, can I have another take on that?
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
But you are doing really great.
Yeah. And I'll probably go back through and just do another take
mm-hmm.
on some of these two, now that you've kind of got the hang of it. And so tell me, talking about the transition from high school into college, has your time management evolved at all? Are there ways in which your time management has changed from high school to
My time management has gotten a lot better at UT because in high school I was able to procrastinate a lot. I was able to maybe study the morning before a test and I would still get an A on it. But in college, you just can't study the morning before and then just get an A. So definitely my time management, I've gotten better at like planning things out and making sure that I have time enough to do everything, because that's definitely important in college.
That is a common theme. So hopefully that message comes through the video. What kind of advice would you give to one of next fall's incoming freshmen?
I would definitely say to not only to join a first-year interest group, but also just work on your time management skills and make sure that you do plan out what you need to do. And also don't get behind. You don't want to get behind on your work and then be struggling to catch up, because that just causes unneeded stress for you whenever like your tests start coming up. So I would say definitely keep on top of things and make sure that you're getting your work done and not, I guess, procrastinating too much like you did in high school.
You feel good with that? You want to try it again?
Okay, yeah.
So tell me about some advice that you would give to an incoming freshman.
I would definitely tell an incoming freshman, should I word it like I'm talking to them? Or like
could
I'm...
Could you look into the camera and say, I'm coming
fresh at that point?
Don't
screw it up.
Yeah. I handled the pressure well, you probably won't.
Yeah, I think just, I think that's fine. Like, my best advice for somebody starting out at UT is blah, blah.
Okay.
Yeah. So what is your best advice for somebody starting out at UT?
My best advice for someone starting out at UT is to not get too behind and to really work on your time management skills and to work on transitioning from how you studied in high school to how you study in college, because it's definitely a big change in what you have to do. And I would say don't procrastinate, keep on top of everything that you need to do. And also don't, I guess, stress yourself out, because that was a big problem with me the first part of my freshman semester, was really just stressing myself out kind of unneededly, and it got kind of overwhelming at times. So I'd say just like relax, work on your work, and just relax and make sure you get everything that you need to do done.
That's the emoting he was talking about. Do you
want to
try it again?
Yes. Okay. Oh, here.
So tell me a piece of advice that you would pass on. What is something that you would tell to a student just starting out at UT?
My best advice to someone just starting out at UT would be to really work on getting everything done on time. Don't get too far behind on your work. You need to work on your time management a little bit in college. And also try to learn how to adjust your studying from high school to studying for college pretty early on, because sometimes it can get overwhelming. And also not to stress themselves out too much, because in my first semester of my freshman year, I definitely stressed myself out a lot. And as the year went on, I've gotten better at not stressing myself out. And I think it's really helped just trying to like relax and not get too overwhelmed.
What are some ways you have found that help to keep it all in perspective so you don't get too stressed out?
I would say that I just tell myself that it's all going to be okay in the end. I don't really have good advice. Like, I know what I do too.
I thought you were about to impart advice to me. I wanted to hear what you had to say. Like, how do I relax?
Yeah, I just tell myself that everything's going to be okay and that you're in a good spot right now, and that really you're here at UT and I don't know.
You've already made it.
I know, that's how I feel. I've already kind of made it pretty far, so.
Do you guys want more on that particular question, or you want
to
look back
to the
beginning?
Maybe let that sit for
a
little while.
Okay.
So then I'm going to probably go back to some of our beginning stuff and just get like a couple more takes on some of those.
Okay.
So let's go back. Let's just do another quick intro of telling me your name, your major, and what small group you're a part of this semester.
My name's Miranda Weed, and I am a biology major, and I'm hoping to do pre-med or pre-dent, and I'm in a first-year interest group this semester.
Tell me a little bit about some of your concerns about transitioning from high school into college.
Coming into college from high school, I was very concerned about meeting new people on such a big campus. And especially I come from a pretty small town of 30,000 people. So coming to a campus that is bigger than your hometown is kind of scary. So I was definitely concerned about meeting new people. And also I was concerned about transitioning from like high school academically to college academically. I was worried about, I guess, the workload in college because I'd heard a lot and I really wasn't sure what to expect really. With it, I didn't know how much harder it would be or if it would be around the same. So that was definitely a concern, just not knowing how much of a difference it was going to be.
That was a great tidbit about your hometown. I think there's going to be a lot of students who can relate to that. Do you guys want another one on that?
Oh, that was great. Can we have the title again, the name?
Yep. Let's do name, major, and what small group you're a part of this semester.
Okay. Should I say hi, or should I just be like, my name's Miranda Weed, or?
Yeah, just my name is.
Okay.
Yeah,
it's fine. All right. I'm sorry, guys.
No, you don't.
Okay.
Just out of curiosity, what small town are you from?
I'm from Lake Jackson, which is hour south of Houston.
Okay.
So pretty tiny, pretty close knit.
The first non-Dallas person we've had.
Oh, really?
Yes, one after another.
Yeah, we've had a lot.
Yeah, I don't know what they are. Yeah.
All right, let's see. My name's Miranda Weed, and I am a biology, either pre-med or pre-dent major, and I am a part of a first-year interest group this semester.
So tell me a little bit about how that small group, that first-year interest group, how have they helped your transition from high school?
Getting into a first-year interest group, you have around, I'd say, around 15 to 20 people who are in the same major as you, who are working towards kind of the same goals. Most of them want to be pre-med or pre-dent or something in the medical field. So it's definitely helped me meet people and make connections with people who are also freshmen, who kind of want to get to the point where you're going. So it's nice to be able to share that with them and to know other people are going through the same things as you. And also, it's nice to have an advisor and a first-year interest group leader who kind of know like the ropes and know how to help you and what to do, like not only with your schedule, but also my first-year interest group leader, she's been through all the classes. She was a bio pre-med major, so she definitely knew like what classes to take, kind of a little bit of like hints of how to succeed in your classes.
Feel good about that? You want to do it again? Or are you okay with
it? Why don't you do it again? That was really good.
Yeah.
There seems to be some second thoughts on your part.
Okay, let's see.
So tell me a little bit about ways in which your small group has helped to facilitate your transition from college to UT, from high school to UT.
So being in a first year interest group is really good because you get to meet a group of people, around 15 to 20 people, who are in your same major and trying to do the same thing that you're trying to do. All of the people in my first year interest group are either pre-med or pre-dent or some like form of wanting to go into the medical field, which is the same as me. So it's nice to be able to not only study with them, which helps with the academics. I'm so sorry.
Oh, no. Yeah. This is great. You're
one of the best interviews we've had.
Yeah.
sometimes I just like lose my train. I don't know.
It happens. it totally.
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
Okay.
Yeah, we've had. I mean, there've been many, many more takes. Like
yeah, most people do about 3 or 4 takes a question. So the fact that you're doing one take on most of these questions is really pretty extraordinary.
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, you're coming across as very natural and approachable,
yeah.
Which is good.
Same question.
Are you good?
Yeah.
Are you ready? Okay.
It gets, these lights are hot. They are very hot.
Yeah, I'm sorry. It's these two over here, actually. These ones over here don't put out any heat.
Oh, really?
Just, yeah, they're just.
Yeah, something is pretty hot.
Yeah.
Maybe, like, I feel like I have a whole new respect, like, for watching people interview. Like, how do you use that?
I don't know how people do it.
You're holding up very, very well. So tell me a little bit about some ways that your small group helped you to transition from high school into college.
My small group definitely helped me in meeting new people who were in the same major as me, and also being able to form connections where I could study with them, or we could just really talk about kind of like our journey and the problems that we're having. I definitely had people who were going through the same things as me. And then my advisor was very good about kind of like helping us plan out our schedules for the future, helping us know what we need to do to graduate on time, and helping us just like know what to expect. And also my first year interest group leader was very good because she is also a bio pre-med major. So she was able to kind of tell us what classes we needed to take as well, and also give us like tips about studying. And they also, they like had a day where we just like learned study tips and how to not stress ourselves out and everything like that.
You feel okay with that?
Maybe we should go on to a different question then if I wanna, yeah, I don't know.
Tell me again, so you talked a little bit before, I don't think I used these specific questions because you asked, or you, a little bit of this came out through another question, but tell me about a self-advising tool that you used this semester, like whether it was downloading your degree plan or using the interactive degree audit, planning, like mapping out your semester's graduation. What kind of tools did you find that helped you to figure out what steps you need to take next?
One thing that I've used a lot, probably a bit too much, is the interactive degree audit. I use it to just make sure I'm on the right track. It gives you like a little percentage saying how much of your degree you've completed, and like it has the years, so like 25%, 50%, 75%, 100%. And it really lets you know like what classes you need to take in the future and what classes like you're taking now. So that's definitely going to help me graduate in 4 years, and it also has helped me plan out my schedule. I'm able to say I need to take this class this semester, this class this semester, and this is what I need to do to graduate in 4 years.
Plugging for your graduation. Let's go back. Tell me one more time about your positive faculty experience.
So in my first year interest group, my chemistry teacher came to talk to us, and it was really interesting because normally it's in a lecture hall with 500 other students, and here we got to see him just pretty much one-on-one. It was like 20 people in a room, so you got to be really close to him and like hear his story, and it really made him not as much of like a scary person like in the front of the room lecturing, but more of a person, and he told us about his like personal life. So that was a really positive experience, getting to hear that he's a real person too, and he's not just some scary professor. Dr. Lottie.
No, he used to work for me. He was scary to me too. But he's a nice guy. Yeah.
Let's go back to something that you discussed.
I've discovered that college is a lot different than high school. I've discovered that it's a lot more work and you can't put things off like you could in high school. But I've also discovered that it's definitely doable if you put the time and the effort into your classes. Like, you can do well in them. And just to be, like, positive and really encourage yourself to try to, can I redo that one? Can I get a different? Okay. Okay.
Tell me about something that you discovered this semester.
I have discovered that high school is a lot different than college, and that college is a lot more work, and that you do have to plan your time out accordingly. However, I've also discovered that you can do it, and that if you put the time and the effort in, you will see, like, your rewards in your classes. I've definitely had those tests that I've studied a lot in advance for, and it's really paid off, and it makes you feel good, and it makes you feel like you've really accomplished something.
Anything else, like organizations or anything that something new, I guess, like something in, as part of the college experience that you didn't expect
of? Let's see. I mean, there's a lot of great organizations that I've, like...
Have you joined it? Have you joined
them? I've joined, like, Women in Medicine and UNICEF and Freshman Leadership Organization.
Okay. So tell me a little bit about getting involved on campus in your first semester. How did you find out about ways to get involved, and how did you ultimately get involved?
So on the first, like, few weeks of classes, they have these huge, like, organization fairs, and you can go and you can just get flyers from, like, everyone. That's what I did, was just go get flyers and see what every group is about. And I also found that getting involved is really pretty easy with the groups, because they're all really welcoming and they want you to come and join and they want you to come have fun. And I found that with all the groups that I've joined, it's been, like, a great experience, because they're all so friendly. And you just have to go out there and try to find them. Can I redo that one too?
Yeah.
Okay.
It was really good though.
My mouth is getting, like, dry. I guess. Yeah,
right,
yeah.
Let's
do that.
Okay. So tell me a little bit about how you found opportunities to get involved this semester, and what you ultimately decided to get involved in.
So in the first few weeks of school, UT puts on these organization fairs out in, like, in front of Gregory, the gym. And it's just, like, almost every organization, it seems like, comes out and they hand you flyers and you can just go see what each group has to offer. So that's what I did, and I found a few groups that I really thought fit what I wanted to be involved in, whether they're service organizations or more, like, academic, kind of, like, geared to what you want to do. So I found a few that I really enjoyed being involved in. And also I found out how, I guess, easy it is to get involved, that everyone is very welcoming whenever you want to join a group. All the officers of the groups that I've joined have been very good at trying to get you integrated into the group.
What about the balance between organizations and academics?
Okay.
Any advice on how to balance that out?
All right, let's see. Let me think for a second. Okay. So with joining organizations and also keeping up with your academics, you definitely have to have a balance. You have to make sure that you're not falling behind on your studies because you're trying to get too involved. I would definitely suggest trying to get involved in organizations and volunteering, but I would also say not to try to, like, spread yourself too thin. I would say, especially first semester of freshman year, to kind of start out slow, maybe get involved in a few groups, check out a few groups, but also really concentrate on your studying as well.
What about, so you talked about coming from a very small town and acclimating to UT, which is larger than your town. What about acclimating to Austin as a whole? What is that transition been like for you?
coming from a small town that I've lived in all of my 18 years, I never moved out of that town. It was crazy moving to Austin, which is so big and so different than from where I'm from. But it was definitely, it's been crazy, it's been different. But I'd say just going out and exploring was really good for me. Going around Austin, just trying to find out where everything is, has been fun, and also just kind of like, I restart that one too. Okay. So wait, what do you want me to say about it? Just like what I, yeah, how
what
I've.
What was the adjustment like? Well, you know, was
okay.
Was it easy? Was it hard? I think you were definitely on the right track in terms of, you know, getting out there and exploring and.
Okay.
Yeah. Acclimating.
Would identifying, like, something like Town Lake or a museum or something along those lines help at all to help kind of conclude some of these thoughts or leading up to?
Okay.
I don't know if that would help you or not. I'm just.
Okay.
Before you start, can you pull your shirt down?
Pull it down?
Oh, there you go.
Okay. All right. You ready? There we go. Okay. All right.
Yeah, so tell me a little bit about what it was like to transition from a smaller town, not only to UT as a large campus, but to Austin as a big city.
So I'm from a town of 30,000 people that I've lived in my whole entire life. I never moved from that city. So it was a lot different moving to Austin, which is so large and so different from where I'm from. But for me, what really helped me get used to Austin was just going out and exploring, like doing some of the more like touristy things in Austin, like going to South Congress, going to Zilker Park, just doing all the things that I guess a true Austinite would do. So that's been very fun, and it's helped me get used to my surroundings and become more comfortable in the city.
I thought it was great. I don't know. I'm pretty comfortable.
I'm pretty comfortable.
Yeah, with what we have.
Too, yeah. Are there other things that you feel like you want to go back and revisit in terms of questions?
Would you like to do the entire interview one more time?
We can do that.
I guess it's up to y'all if y'all feel like if y'all.
Feel,
oh, okay.
No.
I was like, oh.
We wouldn't do that.
Do you have any?
I mean, there's definitely been a lot of things that I've had to adjust to. Let's see. I mean, being away from, like, family? Could I say something like that?
Sure.
Yeah, I think that's something that's very pertinent, too.
Yeah. Because
yeah.
I was. Okay. Let's see.
Where do you live at? Do you live in the dorms?
I live on Jester.
Okay.
Like in Jester.
East or west?
East.
Okay. Yeah. I was then east.
Let's see. I guess the thing is, I haven't had problems with like roommates or anything. I did potluck though, but it worked out so well, which I know doesn't happen for some people. So that's not really an issue.
I mean, I guess. Can you speak to, I guess, like, I guess, a sense of support here? Like, you know, how at home, in high school, whatever, you have your family and they support you.
Mm-hmm.
You have, they support you at all your events and stuff. Here, you're by yourself and, you know, you do your groups and everything, you get support
yeah.
that way. And then maybe, I know for me personally, in Jester, it was like a community. I met a lot of people that way.
Yeah.
Just being in Jester. And, I guess, I don't know. Actually, I don't know what I'm asking for.
I kind of think you're speaking towards the fact that moving here and going out of your way to meet new people is a way to kind of integrate yourself into the UT community. Does that make sense?
All right, let's see. I know I met a lot of people during orientation
uh-huh.
and also just like the first weeks, you really meet a lot of people. So I guess I'll talk about that, just like getting out there your first weeks and really like going to all the events that they put on.
Yeah.
Okay.
Before like all the before the first round of exams.
Yeah, yeah. All right.
Everybody
hunkers down. Alright, let's see. Should I say a little bit about like, cause I came here with like no one to like none of my friends came here.
Talk about
so.
Yeah, I mean we've had a couple of other folks who've been sitting here too saying the same thing that I'm the only person who came here from my high school, from my town, so I was
yep.
basically starting from scratch.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see.
That's my story.
Yeah. Like my best friends at A&M, my best friend of 8 years, like pretty much everyone's at A&M. Okay, let's see. So coming to Austin, I would say one of my biggest concerns was leaving everyone from home behind and coming and pretty much starting over from scratch and having to meet completely new friends. So my advice for meeting new people would be to really get out there, especially in the first few weeks. In the first few weeks, like your dorms, will put on stuff, UT puts on things, different organizations put on things, where you can go out and you can really, it's kind of geared to getting to know people in your first few weeks and getting to make those connections. So I went out and I made a lot of friends that way. And not only just people that you can say hi to, but also really close friendships were started in those first few weeks. So I would say to go out there and try to just, especially before really classes start, that's whenever I met a lot of people, before classes start, and you had that week or two of just getting to be able to go out and meet people. Should I like re-say that?
Yeah,
okay.
Try one more time. That was all very good information.
Okay. All right, let's see. So coming to UT, I would say it was really a big fear of mine to not really meet anyone. Since I was leaving pretty much all of my friends back home or someone to other colleges, and also not having my family support system here, I was very concerned. And I didn't really know how I was going to meet new people. But in the first few weeks, from whenever I moved in to whenever classes start, there's a lot of events going on that you can go to, whether it's volleyball games or organization fairs or things that if you're living in a dorm, the dorm puts on. And it's a really good way to go out there and meet people. It's more geared to meeting people. I live in one of the dorms, and I know in the first week or two, they had a lot of, like, they had speed friending, so you could go out and you could meet people. And that was a good way that I, like, met a lot of people that I still talk to now. Yes.
That's everything I have.
Okay.
Feel comfortable with
that? That's great. I'm happy with it.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Really appreciate it.
I'm sorry that.
No, definitely.
There's nothing to be sorry about.
You did amazing.
All you did was help us out.
Thank you.
You did a really, really good job.